Despite the hazards of conventional insecticides, some use is unavoidable. However, careful chemical choice and application can reduce ecological damage. Although I don't know if application by donkey or even walking through your spray would be the best method. Carefully timed doses can be delivered at vulnerable stages of a pest life cycle or when a pest population is about to explode in numbers. Appropriate and efficient use requires a thorough knowledge of the pest's field biology and an appreciation of the differences among available insecticides. I'm Dr. DeBusk, and in this video I'm going to talk about factors important in a pesticide, modes of action, and synthetic insecticides. Natural insecticides are covered in another video. A pesticide is any material, natural, organic, or synthetic, used to control, prevent, kill, suppress, or repel pests. For arthropod pests, insecticides are used for insects, and miticides or acaricides are used for mite control. Of utmost importance when it comes to pesticides is the effectiveness of insecticides. They can treat an insect problem while it is in progress, reducing numbers to insignificant levels. Another factor is that insecticide action is rapid, usually taking effect within hours and alleviating the problem within a few days. In particular, rapid action allows this tactic to manage a problem by dampening population peaks before major losses are sustained. Insecticides should be economical, at least in the short run, compared with many other pest management tactics. In terms of only the crop, cost-benefit ratios regularly are in the order of $4 to $5 return for every dollar invested in insecticide applications. Finally, insecticides should offer ease of application. People with minimal experience or training should be able to apply them effectively. An array of chemicals have been developed for the purposes of killing insects. These enter the insect body either by penetrating the cuticle, called contact action, by inhalation into the tracheal system, or by oral ingestion into the digestive system. Most contact poisons also act as stomach poisons if ingested by the insect. Toxic chemicals that are ingested by the insect after translocation through the host or plant are called systemic insecticides. These are useful especially in managing scales since their hard waxy covering make it difficult for insecticides to work. Fumigants used for controlling insects are inhalation poisons. Chemical insecticides generally have an acute effect, and their mode of action, that is, their method of causing death, is through the nervous system, either by inhibiting acetylcholine esterase, an essential enzyme for transmission of nerve impulses at synapses, or by acting directly on the nerve cells. Most synthetic insecticides, including pyrethroids, are nerve poisons. Other insecticidal chemicals affect the development of or metabolic processes of insects, either by mimicking or interfering with the action of hormones or by affecting the biochemistry of cuticle production. Chemical insecticides may be synthetic or natural products. Most synthetic insecticides are broad spectrum in action, that is, they have non-specific killing action, and most act on the insect and incidentally on the mammalian nervous system. This also means that these will not only kill the pests but the natural enemies. Organochlorines are stable chemicals and persistent in the environment, are fat soluble, and accumulate in mammalian body fat. Their use is banned in many countries and they are unsuitable for use in IPM. You may have heard of some of these. Pesticides include aldrin, chlordane, DDT, lindane, and dildrin. Organophosphates may be highly toxic to mammals, but are not stored in fat and, being less environmentally damaging and non-persistent, are suitable for use in IPM. Anyone using organophosphates or carbamates should get blood tests periodically to ensure that they're not absorbing pesticides since they are acetylcholine esterase inhibitors. They usually kill insects by contact or upon ingestion, although some are systemic in action, being absorbed into the vascular system of plants so they kill most phloem-feeding insects. Organophosphates include pesticides such as chlorpyrifos, acephate, malathion, and diazinon. Because they are non-persistent, their application must be timed carefully to ensure efficient kill of pests. Carbamates usually act by contact or stomach action, more rarely by systemic action, and they have short to medium persistence. Pesticides include aldicarb, carbaryl, and methomyl. Pyrethrins were originally derived from East African chrysanthemum flowers and were shown to have insecticidal activity. Beginning in the 1970s, synthetic pyrethroids came into the market for agricultural purposes as they were synthesized from pyrethrin derivatives. Their desirable features provide a quick knockdown of insects at low rates, relatively low mammalian toxicity, and improved stability in outdoor environments, which has increased their marketability in agriculture. They are effective against a wide range of insect and mite pests, and they may be mixed with other pesticides for a broad spectrum of pest control. Pyrethroids may be mixed with pyrethroid butoxide, a synergist, which enhances the effect of the active ingredient. Their mode of action is interference with transmission of nerve impulses. Although nicotine-based insecticides have been phased out for reasons including high mammalian toxicity and limited insecticidal activity, the new generation of nicotinoids or neonicotinoids, which are synthetic pesticides modeled on natural nicotine, have a large market, in particular the systemic insecticide imidacloprid, which is used against a range of insect pests. Neonicotinoids selectively target the nicotinic acetylcholine receptors in the insect's central nervous system and cause paralysis and death, often within a few hours. They pose a lower threat to mammals and the environment and can be applied at water-soluble applications or seed coatings as a systemic pesticide. They control soil insects that feed on roots, above and below ground-flowing feeding bugs, and leaf and stem-feeding beetles. Neonicotinoids are toxic to bees, so bee precautions must be taken when applying, such as minimizing drift, applying pesticides when plants are not in bloom, and avoiding applications when bees are around. The phenylpyrazole insecticide Fipronil is a contact and stomach poison that acts as a potent inhibitor of gamma-aminobutyric acid, GABA-regulated chloride channels in neurons of insects, but is less potent in vertebrates. However, this poison and its degradates are moderately persistent, and one photodegradate, a breakdown product produced by exposure to light, appears to have an acute toxicity to mammals that is about 10 times that of fipronil itself. Although human and environmental health concerns are associated with its use, it is very effective in controlling many soil and foliar insects, for treating seed, and as a bait formulation to kill ants, vespid wasps, termites, and cockroaches. Fipronil in baits is taken back to the nests of social insects by foraging workers and can kill the entire colony. This is also common in flea medicines for animals. Insect growth regulators, IGRs, are compounds that affect insect growth via interference with metabolism or development. They offer a high level of efficiency against specific stages of many insect pests, with a low level of mammalian toxicity. The two most commonly used groups of IGRs are distinguished by their mode of action. Chemicals that interfere with the normal maturation of insects by disturbing the hormonal control of metamorphosis are the juvenile hormone mimics. These synthetic analogs of juvenile hormone halt development so that the insect either fails to reach the adult stage or the resulting adult is sterile and malformed. Examples of pesticides include phenoxycarb, methoprene, and pyrethroxifen. The chitin synthesis inhibitors, such as bupropion and diflubenzuron, prevent the formation of chitin, which is a vital component of insect cuticle. Typically, the affected insects shed the old cuticle partially or not at all, and if they do succeed in escaping their exuvae, their body is limp and easily damaged as a result of the weakness of the new cuticle. In addition to the chemical and physical properties of insecticides, their toxicity, persistence in the field, and method of application are influenced by how they are formulated. Formulation refers to what and how other substances are mixed with the active ingredient and largely constrains the mode of action. Insecticides may be formulated in various ways, including as solutions or emulsions, as wettable powders that can be dispersed in water, as dusts or granules that are mixed with an inert carrier, or as gaseous fumigants. The formulation may include abrasives that damage the insect cuticle and or baits that attract the insects. For example, fipronil often is mixed with fish meal bait to attract and poison pest ants and wasps. The same insecticide can be formulated in different ways according to the application requirements, such as aerial spraying of a crop versus domestic use. In conclusion, synthetic insecticides can be a part of integrated pest management, although some of these insecticides can affect natural enemies and pollinators or have mammalian toxicity. Careful planning and use is important when incorporating these pesticides into your program.